Now this is the next point. If a polynomial has only one type of variable, then it is the polynomial in one variable. For example, 2x cube plus 3x square plus x plus 1, x cube minus x square, etc. In these two expressions, there is only one type of variable. Here in this expression, x is the variable. In this expression also, x is only the variable. Next, if a polynomial has two types of variables, then it is the polynomial in two variables. For example, x square plus y square, x cube plus y square plus 1, a square plus b minus 1. So here in each expressions, there are two types of variables, xy, xy, ab. The next is, if a polynomial has three types of variables, then it is the polynomial in three variables. That is, x plus y minus z, x square plus y plus z cube minus 1, x cube plus 3y plus z. In these expressions, there are three types of variables are there. Next is very important point. An algebraic expression is a polynomial if it satisfies the following conditions. If an algebraic expression satisfies these two conditions, then only it is a polynomial. The first condition is, power of the variable must be a whole number. Power of the variable cannot be negative or fraction. Okay, it should be a whole number itself. Then the coefficient of the variable must be a real number. That means, how it will not be a real number? Negative numbers root. Negative numbers cube root. That all are not real numbers. Okay, coefficient of the variable must be real number. Now we can see some examples. First one, x square minus 5x. It is a polynomial because it satisfies the conditions. The next, x raised to minus 2 minus 3x. It is not a polynomial. Why? Its power is not a whole number. This power of x is negative 2. It is negative number. The next is root 3x plus 2. It is a polynomial because root 3 is a real number. That is the variable of the coefficient of the variable x. Power of the variable is a whole number 1. The next is root x plus 3. It is not a polynomial. Why? The power of root x is 1 by 2. That means root x equal x raised to 1 by 2. So this 1 by 2 is not a whole number. It is a fraction. Next, 3 by x square minus 5. It is also not a polynomial. Why it is? 3 by x square we can write as 3x raised to negative 2. That you already studied in 8th standard in the chapter exponents and powers. So the power of x is not a whole number. It is negative. So it is not a polynomial. Then next example is x square plus root 5. It is a polynomial. Root 5 is a term, not a coefficient. Or if it is a coefficient also, it is a polynomial because root 5 is a real number. Okay. Then the last one, root negative 4x square minus 3x. It is not a polynomial. Why it is? The coefficient of x square, coefficient of the variable is root negative 4. Root negative 4 is not a real number. Root of a negative number is not a real number. Next point is, when a polynomial has only one term, that is a number, then it is called a constant polynomial. A polynomial has only one term and that term is a number, then it is called a constant polynomial. For example, 2, negative 3, etc. Its degree is 0. There is no variable, so its degree is 0. Then 0 is also a constant term. That means it is also a constant polynomial. And if the constant polynomial 0 is also known as 0 polynomial. If a polynomial with the term 0 then it is known as zero polynomial. Its degree is not defined. Its degree is not defined. Constant polynomial's degree is zero, but zero polynomial's degree is not defined.